There is an ingredient out there that you can both eat and you can put it on your face. It has been scientifically proven to help people burn more fat, and it's been scientifically proven to help wound healing, such as scars, scabs, and marks left by acne, as well as helping the skin repair faster and fighting aging, preventing and maybe even reversing signs of UV damage. Have any idea what this is? You can ingest it, you can put it on your face, and it makes you feel awake. What is it? In today's video, we are going to be discussing the scientific literature's take on matcha for both your body and your skin. Have you ever heard of matcha, or have you ever had green tea? We're going to discuss the 5 biggest nutritional and skincare benefits and get a little science-y with it, and talk about how science says that these things can help your body, your mind, and your skin. The first one is catechins. Now, what the heck is a catechin? A catechin is basically a classification of water-soluble antioxidants. You remember from the other skincare videos that we've done that antioxidants are like knights or princesses in shining armor. They run around your body or your skin and they attack harmful invaders called free radicals. Free radicals cause a lot of damage. Imagine free radicals as like the 5-year-old kid who is having a fizzy tantrum, but he's also on a sugar high and he's got a sledgehammer in his hands. Free radicals go around and they destroy cells, they destroy DNA, and they destroy a healthy skin and body function. Well, antioxidants are like that knight in shining armor, and they basically have whatever it is that this kid wants in order to shut him up. Whether it is food, whether it is attention, whether it is a story, these antioxidants basically have all of these extra electrons, and they're like, hey, free radical, stop destroying things. Take this instead. And that way your body is saved. Catechins are a type of antioxidant. The most abundant one that's found in green tea and white tea is known as EGCG, otherwise known as epigallocatechin 3-gallate. That's basically just this long scientific term. But this is a very special antioxidant. When it comes to actually consuming EGCG, it has been scientifically proven to help people burn fat when trying to lose weight. They had a scientific study where people went on walks, and those who drank matcha green tea with EGCG burned more fat. This study showed that not only did it increase that fat oxidization or that fat usage, but it also boosted metabolism. So for those who are trying to lose weight and just decrease your body's fat percentage, green tea might be the way to go. But how does this special antioxidant work within the skin? In skin, it's been shown to be from 10 to 25 times more potent than vitamin A, and from 10 to 75 times more potent than vitamin C, which means it is a huge boost to any skincare routine. We know that damage happens to our skin in many ways, and a lot of times that comes from not only products that we use, but from our environment, meaning harsh conditions and UV rays from the sun. The EGCG antioxidants in here can actually help fight those UV rays, fight the damage and the free radicals that become, that kind of proliferate in your skin because of that, and mitigate how that impacts your skin. Can also help to increase collagen. Remember, collagen is kind of like the rubber band that holds your skin together, so that your skin is firmer, repairs better, and you can prevent or decrease the effect of wrinkles or little creases. Next, let's talk about chlorophyll. Who remembers learning about biology and remembers what chlorophyll is? Chlorophyll is what makes plants green. It's how plants turn the sunlight into energy and carbon dioxide. Well, guess what? Chlorophyll is actually really good for your body and your skin as well. Chlorophyll is actually very similar to hemoglobin, otherwise known as blood. And there have been studies that show that when people actually drink more chlorophyll and just mix it into their water or add it to their diet by eating their greens, that their blood can actually become richer, meaning that you can transport more oxygen to the cells and organs in your body. Faster brain function, faster learning, better circulatory system and heart function for exercise or chasing your cats around the backyard. But when applied topically, for instance, if someone adds it to a skincare routine, it's actually been shown to help the healing process, such as acne marks, scars, and other blemishes. On top of that, it also might be antimicrobial, meaning it helps to fight microbes that could be the cause of breakouts and skin irritation. There have been studies that show that when applied to atopic dermatitis or contact dermatitis, which are essentially eczema, really dry, flaky, rough, and patchy skin, using chlorophyll in a topical form can can actually help decrease the itchiness, the pain, and the exasperation that happens to the skin because of that. We also can't forget about L-theanine, which is an amino acid. If you remember, amino acids are what make up proteins. And when you drink these amino acids or when you apply them to your skin, they can do some pretty powerful things. You might have heard that matcha tea or green tea can help improve your mood, but there's actual scientific evidence for it. When people eat or drink this L-theanine amino acid, it can actually improve neurological function. When it comes to brain function, we have synapses in between our nerves that use neurotransmitters to transmit messages. Basically, if I'm feeling happy, that's how my brain is going to know and how it's going to connect to my body. Now, there are some neurotransmitters that are very widely known. Have you ever heard of serotonin or dopamine or epinephrine, norepinephrine, adrenaline? These are all kind of the happy chemicals. Well, guess what? This amino acid that's in the matcha tea plays an impact when it comes to this little area called the synapse. In the synapse, where these little neurotransmitters, aka messengers, do their work. Consuming this amino acid has been shown to increase the GABA neurotransmitter. This is a neurotransmitter that is essential to healthy and happy brain function that can improve mood. And the study that some scientists did actually showed that it could help people with ADHD improve their mood and focus and concentrate better. ADHD is a condition where people get a little bit distracted.
Fuzzy Wuzzy was a bear, was he?
Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder. My family members and I have a little taste of it, and I'm not gonna lie, it can be fun, but it can also be very life disrupting. And when it comes to being able to use foods or supplements as another tool in a toolbox to manage that kind of condition, it's natural, it has all these benefits, and it can increase your mood. It's something that I should probably consume a little bit more of. And how about these amino acids when applied to skin? Well, some of these amino acids are small enough to break through the skin's barrier. And this happens to be one of them. It's actually been shown to decrease inflammation. And as we know, one of the four main pillars of acne is inflammation. So if this amino acid can fight that inflammation, it could help with things such as acne and actually decreasing the amount of scarring or marks that are left behind. The study that I'm quoting specifically looks at downregulating endothelial cell function. Endothelial cells are all throughout your entire body, especially in the heart and in the veins, but they're very important and they play major roles all throughout the body. But when it comes to inflammation, they can control inflammation throughout the entire body. So again, this is something that's good for your skin, but for the rest of you as well. And lastly, let's talk about xanthines. Now, what the hell does that word mean? A xanthine is basically any kind of alkaloid, which in chemistry is how we categorize and organize different compounds. Kind of like if you're organizing your closet, chemists and scientists do that with molecules to know how they'll react with one another, just the way you would put your long sleeve sweaters together so that you know what to wear them with when you're cold versus your tank tops or t-shirts for the summer. One type of xanthine is caffeine, which you're probably very familiar with. In the body, xanthines work to break down nucleic acid into uric acid, basically your digestion process. So these help to upregulate digestion and metabolism, meaning that you have a faster metabolism and you're turning your proteins into basically how your body is going to use them or how you're going to pee them out. And helps your body function in a healthy way. But what happens when you put these on your face? In tests, xanthines that have been applied to skin have actually been shown to stop wrinkles and UV damage and to upregulate collagen. Again, these rubber bands that keep the skin firm and young looking and fresh and kind of bouncy means our skin is going to create more of those in the right places and overall give us a more fresh and glowing look. And when it comes to that UV factor, again, those damaging rays that can happen from the sunlight, it helps to stop the amount of impact that those are going to have on destroying your skin, kind of putting the brakes on that process. And of course, vitamins. You know that you need to have vitamins for a healthy functioning body. They do everything from help you to create cells, to digest different compounds when you eat, to be able to be happy again with those neurotransmitters and other signals. But vitamins are also great for your skin. Vitamin A has been shown to actually decrease oil production. Vitamin C can lead to anti-aging and wound healing. Vitamin E especially can help with scarring. And guess what? Green tea and matcha green tea has so many vitamins. And again, in amounts that are much higher than just a regular tea. When it comes to it, I do want to give a recommendation of the type of matcha that I drink along with the skincare. When it comes to drinking matcha, you want to make sure that you're getting a pure source. Just check those ingredient labels and make sure that the company isn't putting any sugar or fillers on it. It should say 100% matcha, and if it says organic or if it says grown with baby tea leaves, that's generally going to be a little bit better for you. A good test you can do is by looking at how green it is. Remember that the brighter colors means the more antioxidants and power that those plants have. That's why doctors always tell you to eat the rainbow. When it comes to skin, you can get matcha in a whole bunch of variations. I would recommend ones that actually stay on your skin, not just a cleanser that you wash off, but something like a mask that you leave on for 15 to 20 minutes, or a moisturizer that you can leave on all day. I have oily, acne-prone skin, so this is a matcha green tea mask that actually has matcha as well as kaolin clay. Kaolin clay is great for combating oil without disrupting the skin's barrier. It can really get rid of toxins and help to clear out blackheads as well. This specific mask is from Teamy and it also has aloe vera in it. And as we know from other videos, aloe vera is extraordinarily hydrating to the face. And it's natural with a bunch of antioxidants too. If we look at these ingredients, the first one is water, second is bentonite clay, third is kaolin clay, and the fourth is your matcha. That means that there's actually a lot of matcha in here. It's not just a little extract that they put at the bottom with a bunch of cosmetic fillers. This is actually the potent stuff that you're getting your money's worth for. It's also got a vegetable-based glycerin and sweet almond oil, which are both very hydrating to the skin, and the sweet almond oil generally has a high concentration of vitamin E, which on top of the vitamin E in the matcha, remember, can help with scarring and things like that. We've got a little bit of lemongrass in there and a couple of preservatives, but for my oily, acne-prone skin, this is really amazing.
Hello, friends! Good morning! Oh my god, could you imagine waking up to this in the morning?
I love waking up to matcha. If I have a few extra minutes in the morning, I put it on my face and, of course, in my cup. This mask and my latte are amazing for all of the matcha benefits discussed, but also this mask is specifically made of both kaolin and bentonite clay. So if you've ever used the Indian healing clay mask, it's a little bit similar in that aspect, but I find that it's not as drying because it has that glycerin in there. It actually hydrates the skin and it kind of feels almost like a little bit tingly, not painful, but just like revitalizing and awake. Just the way caffeine makes your brain feel. How this feels on my face. And it's got that aloe vera and vitamin E in there, so when it sits on my skin, it is nice and comfortable. And I would say over the past month or so, if I have a few extra minutes in the morning, if I'm waking up early to read, shut up, microwave. If I'm waking up early morning to read or something, I'll actually just put this on. You know, I find that my skin doesn't get that dirty when I sleep, so I don't see the need to like wash and strip and do a full skincare routine in the morning. If you've seen my morning and evening routines, you know that. But I've been putting this on, especially on areas that I get oily, and then I can literally just rinse it off and put on a moisturizer or a sunscreen, go throughout my day, and then at the end of the day, do my full skincare routine. But we're gonna let this dry on the face, let it get a little crunchy, and then I'm gonna let those antioxidants get to work, and then I'm gonna get to work, because it's... What time art thou? Ah, 'tis 5:59 in the morning. Why am I awake? The person that actually got me hooked on this is another YouTuber named Dr. Dre. I had no idea who she was until somebody from our butterfly family pointed her out to me. And holy guacamole, this woman is a genius. I'm like, yes, somebody who gets it. She's a licensed dermatologist. She talks all about skincare and I am obsessed with her content. And I'm like, how have I not seen one of your videos sooner? The YouTube algorithm must be hella broken. If you don't know who she is, please go check her out because she is amazing and I have her to thank for getting me hooked on this. And tell her that Cassandra Bankson sent you and send her a little bit of butterfly love so that we can all see who other butterflies are there and just spread the positivity. So when it comes to matcha, there are so many amazing benefits for your face, for your body, etc. And if you feel that you've been stuck in a rut, whether it's with your skincare routine, whether it's with your body, or whether it's just with your mental state, matcha might be able to help. So that being said, I hope that you guys learned something from this video. I love geeking out like this. And if you did enjoy this, please give it a thumbs up so that I know to create more content like this. If you didn't enjoy it, give it a thumbs down. That's still valuable feedback for me. But also smash the subscribe button so you don't miss future videos of talking about matcha and science and nutrition and skincare or just me chasing my cats around the backyard. I love you guys so much and I appreciate you being here with me to both learn and get inspired. Always remember to be beautiful and I can't wait to see you in the next video. Love you guys. Bye.